All right, October 16th. We got a lot of things going down. Still going to church. Still part of a lot of clubs. A few topics we want to talk about tonight.
Quite a bit.
Have to say, new clubs, lame clubs, senior look, still going on. Spirit Week, senior privileges, many other things. Homecoming. We're gonna cover it all tonight.
Homecoming week.
Here on Adam's Diaries with Mike. Mike and Adam's Diaries. That's right. Unofficial title. But yeah, October 16th.
It works. It works.
So, let's get started. Get down to business.
Dude, let's get the lowdown.
Yes, let's get low.
Let's get low.
Okay, as I mentioned before, I'm still going to church, Sacred Heart. I'm still part of a lot of clubs. You know, I got some new clubs, and unfortunately, I did drop some clubs, like Drama Club. Well, I'm still a part of Drama Club, but...
Who called that one?
I'm not part of the play, Arsenic and Old Lace. It's over with. I'm done with it. Some new clubs that I did join. Math Club, I do like that a lot. It's a fun club. I get a lot of people to join it, too. Like, today we had two girls that had to give a ride home. Brianna and her friend Roxanne. Who looked like Carmen Electra.
She looked exactly like Carmen Electra in the face. Like,
it was like really
from here up, it's like a replica.
So, I also got Push Up Crew. I'm on that. And I haven't really actually done that, but I like to wear the shirt around and, you know, everyone kind of like pays respect and stuff.
Hey,
kind of cool.
That's how it is.
Mike's, you know.
I've been doing a lot of things. I've been doing a lot of things this year, especially with homecoming week.
Mm-hmm.
Well, where should I start?
Let's start with the volleyball stuff.
Dude, super fans.
That's a kind of a new kind
like
of club.
The thing is, it all started with just going to the volleyball games, and since, you know, a lot of the clubs around Charlotte High, they don't get as much recognition as, say, football and basketball, but all the guys, like, we enjoy going to the volleyball games, so we started doing a super fan kind of deal. We weren't necessarily, like, cheerleaders, but we're there to pump up the crowd, just get things going, all like, overall. And Adam went to the first volleyball game, what was it, Thursday?
Mm-hmm.
But he just happened to go when we played number one state-ranked Venice, and they kicked our ass. But that's okay. See, my first game was also against Venice, except mine was away. So I had to drive like 50 miles, literally, just to like watch us get our ass handed to us.
So I guess I had the same effect in a way.
So I guess that means every other game you go to, we're just going to win. Because that's the only game I've been to where we didn't win in three games.
Okay. So every other game we're going to win?
Yeah.
If I go?
I think so.
I'm like a good luck charm now or something? Or maybe I'm like the bringer of bad luck. We'll see what happens.
Nah, I think you're the good luck charm.
Okay.
That's what I'm going with.
All right.
But then, it kind of evolved into Powder Puff cheerleading. Powder Puff cheerleading.
Powder Puff cheerleading. That was a lot of fun today, Wendy.
So, yeah, I mean, we'll get to that later. Okay. We can wait till our Thursday on our weekly perspective kind of deal.
All right. Alright, back to the updates. The senior look, as I said before, it's still going on. Let's get a close up. Whoa! Wow!
So, yeah, as you remember from our previous edition, I believe it was August 23rd or somewhere along those lines, this hair up in here was all like short.
August 23rd?
Yeah, his hair was all like really short, but now, as you can see, it's increasing a lot in length.
This is basically like an update from August 23rd. It's been a while, so it's definitely an appropriate time, being homecoming week and all.
Also, in the end of the first quarter.
Oh, that is correct. So it's perfect.
Dude, this
in a way,
is
this is
perfect.
Like, this is meant to be right now.
This is like our quarterly update of our senior year.
Another update, as I said before, the senior privileges are in full effect. All the underclassmen definitely look up to us. Yes, thank you. Being Spirit Week and all, as I mentioned, there's been many days this week where I decided, you know, to show my true tarpon pride. First off, there's Twin Day. Now, this got off to a rocky start, you know. I had a twin for the first class, something Nathan, but he kind of like changed his clothes. And it wasn't that big of a deal, you know. No one really got too big of a deal with Twin Day. Now, the best day, Tuesday, the best day of Spirit
Superhero Day.
Both me and Mike, dressed up like Party Boy. All right.
As you know, Party Boy's
now,
the jackass.
Many of you may not have known what Party Boy is or anything, but if you don't know, this might, you know, bring back some memories. Alright, so basically, Party Boy, I guess I lost my shirt, so we're just gonna go without that for now. Let's turn this down. Okay, so, Mike, get back in this.
You know, I'm still getting dressed.
I lost my shirt. I don't know where it went.
So you threw it at me. It's I just got the microphone.
Okay. Technical difficulties. Sorry.
Testing 1, 2. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Get back on there.
Alright, we're on.
Alright, we're on. Okay. Okay, back to what I was saying with Party Boy and all. Both me and Mike dressed up. If I might add, here is the
official Party Boy pants.
Official Party Boy pants, if you can notice, listen.
They rip apart. They break away really easily.
Pretty much, they just rip them off. It's a lot of fun. Official Party Boy jacket here. You wear it, you zip it. Zip it and rip it, as I like to say.
Official Party Boy thong.
Official Party Boy is what I like to call the thong, which got much reputation.
It's more like a man thong, I don't know, it's kind of different.
Throw that over there. Alright, that was a big hit. Now, I'm officially known as Party Boy now in school. Like, everyone, like the underclassmen and all, they all think of me as like Party Boy. So that was a lot of fun. I had a great time that day. Now, I had even more fun. Well, no, I had the most fun was on Superhero Day. Retro Day,
quite interesting.
Was like.
You think that Christopher Reeves?
I can move. Okay. So, Retro Day was a lot of fun because I got to dress like my dad in 1977. I got to wear his class ring. I got to wear his leather jacket. I got to wear his pants, his boots, and I got to bring in the boombox. I also did the same thing with Party Boy, the boombox. It had a great effect.
Well, that was part of the whole deal.
Oh, man.
I could just carry it over on the Wednesday.
Yeah, I ripped off my pants to add on to Party Boy. I ripped off my pants in Miss W when I was party boying her like this. I just like ripped them off. The class was like uproarious with like laughter. Well, not really laughter, but just like they were just like, ah! Like they're just going insane and everything. And I just like ran to the bathroom in my underwear because I kind of like lost my pants and stuff in the classroom somewhere. And I got them back, but it was a lot of fun. And everyone thought it was awesome. Then today was Blue and Gold Day. I just wore my push-up crew shirt with some gold-colored swimming trunks. And what did you wear today, Mike? Oh, yes. You might want to elaborate on that.
Well, Wednesday afternoon, that was Retro Day. But we had Powderpuff cheerleading practice. And basically, you know, if you don't know, Powderpuffs win. The girls play football and the boys are the cheerleaders. So me and about, I don't know, 12, 15 other guys. Did you have a count?
I'd say about 15.
Yeah, there's approximately 15 of us. And we got to wear cheerleading skirts to school today. You know, we had the frilly shirts, the beads and the glitter and the paint. It was quite elaborate. But then today after school, there was the Powerpuff game, big hit. Seniors won, of course. So, yeah. I was pretty excited about that.
Score?
Actually, it was 8-7. Because, you know, with a few minutes left, seniors marched all the way down the field, got the score, and it was a 7-6 game. They decided to go for 2 points rather than kick the extra point. So, luckily they made it, because if they missed it, it's like you have one shot, one opportunity.
One, yeah.
But hey, worked out in the seniors' favor, as always.
Yes. Unfortunately, for all those who might have watched our last video, we have not played Truth or Truth since that.
Actually, we have. But wait, they don't know about the stories.
Stories.
My September stories.
Go ahead. Let's go for the September story.
Girl next door, man.
Sarah, man?
Yeah, man.
Dude, let's talk.
Dude, let's talk.
We have time.
We have all the time in the world. All right, well, basically, Truth or Truth, if you were watching the last video, involved Sarah. And since then, Sarah and I, and Adam actually as well, you know, we dated.
Not like a trio. Like, it's definitely not like a trio. Just for the
I meant like, oh, damn. This is key.
Write this down.
You're going to want this in your notes.
This is critical, as Dugan would say.
Damn. But yeah, basically, I guess Sarah led me on a little bit. I felt kind of gay. But, not quite as gay as...
Not quite as gay as
Mr. Hall. And a little more gay than I
You just got yourself in a prediction.
It was a little more gay than today with the cheerleading outfit, but, but yeah, I don't know. It was like a 2-day thing, you know, 48-hour fling. We didn't even hug. Just, I don't know. Adam and her kept telling me how much they liked me, how much she liked me. And it just faded off. But what can you do? Women will be women.
So, as Mike is saying this, it reminded me of this little thing I decided to bring up. This little chart Mike has not seen.
Dude.
Isn't this kind of interesting? I didn't really add too much to it. But just for those at home who want to read that, who want to maybe like get some info on this, I'll read this off. I'll have Mike. We'll read every other. I'll start off. You know, August 25th. Wait, when was our last video?
Dude, it was August 23rd.
August 23rd. What do you know? Two days later.
We have a timeline.
Adam and Sarah decide to spontaneously go out and break up 2 hours later on the phone.
Damn.
Damn is
September
right.
September 2003.
Not sure when.
Date Mike goes out with Sarah.
Remember that day? Because maybe I can fill it in.
Actually, I might be able to find that out.
We'll find that out. So next we have September sometime. Sarah breaks up with Mike. Sarah goes out with Nick.
Same day.
So we'll just use variable X in both equations.
No. We'll use variable X in the first one and X plus 2.
The same day, though, man.
No, it wasn't.
I thought it was the same day.
We went out and broke up two
days later. Oh, yeah. Plus 2.
With you, it was...
Sounds good.
Okay.
September 12th, Aaron asked Monica out. It's a big step.
That was a big step.
It was definitely Monica's birthday party at Fisherman's Village, and I remember it distinctly, so...
September 21st, 2003.
Do you remember that day?
Roxanne! It might go out.
Jordan's College, Orlando.
Actually, yeah, it was kind of funny. I asked her out, like, 300 miles away. It's kind of funny.
Here's another unverified date, September 22nd, ? Monica breaks up with Aaron over the phone. I'm not completely sure about that, because I know when it happened, but I don't know what exact day it happened. So, there you have it.
September 30th, 2003. Roxanne breaks up with Mike.
I love how each of these seem to like follow, like one of them's yours and one of them's kind of like mine. Okay, October 1st, Aaron wants to go to homecoming with Adam.
See, have I met Aaron?
I don't think so.
Dude, why haven't I met her?
Chris knows her.
Why haven't I met her, man?
You'll meet her at homecoming.
October 5th, 2003. Nate asked Monica to homecoming and vice versa.
Yes, actually. October 6th, Adam learns school plays they suck. And Nathan learns it's okay to procrastinate Miss Perry's class.
How do you learn that?
She doesn't grade all the assignments. He just stopped doing all the assignments. And you did what you did. You want to tell the audience what you did with the essay? That essay that we're
supposed to write? Which essay?
Cause and effect. The outline. The essay.
Oh, where I gave the finger?
Yeah, and then you wait till the last day.
Yeah, well, basically, we're supposed to have our outlines on the Wednesday. I didn't do it. We're supposed to have the full rough draft on that Friday. Didn't do it. Didn't 2 days ago from today, I think it was a Tuesday, the full completed draft of the essay and the outline were due. So I decided to wake up Tuesday morning, do the outline, and third hour I wrote the essay, so it was pretty nice.
Let me just take a moment here and take a drink here for my Wendy's. Very refreshing beverages.
Absolutely.
As I was saying, as this is homecoming week and all, let's talk about the night and how it may turn out, because we all know things can blow up in your face. I, as you heard before, am going with Aaron to homecoming. Now, whether that's going to be, you know, a great monumental event or a
dud,
or just, you know, just a fun time. I doubt it will be a dud or anything awful is going to happen, but you never know, you know, this day and age. So, I just like to say, for the record, maybe the next diary I can say, like, what happened, like, the outcome, but just kind of leave you in suspense. Leave, kind of create your own ending. That's what I'm trying to go for here.
Use and your imagination.
Pretty much use your imagination. Now, Mike here will tell you about his plan so far.
Oh, for homecoming? Mm-hmm. Well, tomorrow I know the parade starts. Both Adam and I are going to be in the parade. We have a football game tomorrow night. Basically, same thing as tonight. We're just getting our names called. Blah, 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 blah. Then, Saturday, the big day. We're going to spend most of it at Brady's house. Maybe not most of it. But at least some of it at Brady's house. And then, I know we're going to Hooters beforehand. Go eat. You know, that's important, I
go
think.
Go eat and go eat.
Dude, as seniors, you know, it's my life, it's now or never.
Yeah.
You know, we're gonna go to Hooters before homecoming. So, yeah.
As I'd like to say, guess who just called a few minutes ago?
Nigga, please.
J-Lo called, actually. The song might perhaps remind you of J-Lo, also known as Jordan, because he likes to listen to Super Mario Techno. Actually, this is the song that I actually heard from him first.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So, J-Lo, if you're watching this, just want you to know, I love you, man.
Dude.
You've been a great friend.
Much love.
Double punch. Man, I love you. I just want you to know that.
In like a non-homosexual way.
I honestly love you.
Extremely non-homosexual way.
I won't even go there, so, you know. I'm known as home video, so I don't even want to, like, say anything else.
Yeah, basically.
I guess we're gonna act a fool.
Well, apparently, Jordan's coming down tomorrow. I don't know, it's gonna be nice to see him since, like, mid-September. You know, mid-September, we went up to Orlando.
Right.
I mentioned this a little bit whenever I told you about how I asked Roxanne out there. But, I was doing a bitch. Actually, Orlando was a lot of fun. We got a bottle of Hypnotic with us, got some Cardio 3, some Smirnoff Ices, and hung out in Jordan's dorm and had a hell of a time. I mean, went up there, played in some tournaments of the Meriden pre-release, and I enjoyed myself.
We got a new thing coming up, too, in Jordan's place.
Yeah, it's not tomorrow, but the weekend after that, we're going to be going up for States.
We're also going to pretty much get a hotel, Halloween Horror Nights in Orlando.
Actually, dude, I don't know about that anymore.
Really?
Yeah. It's a lot of money.
Oh, how much?
Dude, it's like $50 just to get in.
All right, well, I guess we'll have to, like, live without that.
Fuck that.
Okay, I guess we'll invest our money in something else, more wiser.
But yeah, I'm thinking Friday night we're going to get up there kind of late, and we'll probably go out to dinner, and then we'll just go in the hotel room and chill.
So like Carrabba's?
Dude, maybe. Dude, last time we went up there, it was just me and Adam, I believe. We met Chris up there, but we went to Carrabba's, and I thoroughly enjoyed myself. We spent like $40 between us. Totally worth it. Totally worth it.
And then bragging to Schrader. You know, by the way, not to bring this up again, but I did party boy Schrader. Not seriously? With pants off, pants on, but she was running around this other girl, and she was like, ah, I've never seen you act this way, ah. And it was actually a lot of fun to do that to Schrader. Because she was supposed to get pied in the face, and getting party boy in the face is a lot better than getting pied in the face.
Oh, definitely, definitely.
She'll, like, look back on these days. Love those. And I also wanted to say, college visits, you know, I love them. I went to go visit my friend James last weekend, maybe, or the weekend before.
I think it was about two weekends ago,
the weekend before that. I went and did that, and I'm definitely going to do it to some other friends, you know, other colleges, check them out. It's a good thing.
Well, see, I'd like to bring
Mike here, go down and visit James. I mean, he'd really like it. I mean, there's a lot of cool guys there. It's like, I had a really great time, actually, and a lot of beer. Like, you don't have to pay for it. They have, like, a bunch of refrigerators full of it, and they don't care if you drink it. I actually have, like, a funny story to tell about it, if you actually want to hear it.
Dude, let's hear it. Like, we got time.
Okay, they have these people that are called, like, I think, what they call, like, TAs. I want to say TAs, but they're, like, people that go around and check the rooms. And apparently they don't always do this. They do this maybe, like, once every 3 months or something. They like, never come in your room or anything. But just so happened the night that I was there, we all had, like a beer, like, sitting out somewhere. And they just, like, came in and were like, are you all over 21? And we were like, we weren't, like, none of us were. And then, this one dude ran to the door, and he's like, yeah, you know, my roommate, he's sleeping right now, but he gets his beer and stuff. And they're like, just make sure you dump him out so that you don't have any, if you have any other people under 21, not to do that. And he's like, oh, okay, yeah, sure, here, we'll do it right here. And then, like, we just, like, dumped him all out. It was such a waste, kind of, but, I mean, it's worth it because they didn't get in trouble or anything, so. It was funny, though.
That is kind of interesting.
If you were there, it would be... I almost flipped out. This lady just, like, she just opened the door and just, like, walked in. And I was like...
What if you had your door locked?
Then you probably couldn't do it, but our door was wide. They leave their doors, like, open so everyone can just come visit. But it never happened. This is, like, something that never happened, so... It was...
Intense.
It was pretty intense. We were acting a fool, I guess.
Dude, acting a fool.
Yeah. We got... J-Man coming, got homecoming. Actually, I plan to go to Olive Garden. Yeah. Alright, so I just thought I'd say that.
So, I'll see you there.
I guess I don't know. I guess I can't go to Hooters, man. I'd actually like to, but I already made that plan.
Priorities.
Sorry, man.
Bros before hoes.
What do you say? Don't make me feel guilty, man. Seriously, this is, like, not cool.
It's fine. I really don't give a shit.
Alright. Who do you got going to Hooters anyway? Like, Kevin?
Alright, Kevin, Brady,
you,
me, Christian.
Christian,
There's actually a few more. I just can't think of them offhand. It's kind of late. It's 11 o'clock.
They, like, home. You want to go home. Shang, he's a cool guy.
Dude, Shang Wei.
He's getting kind of,
arrogant, I want to say.
He is getting pretty arrogant. Dugan's class. I mean, I would not do some of the stuff that he'd do in Dugan's. Like, for instance, play music during class.
Yeah, like, randomly in class, he'll go back in the computer and, like, put a CD in. Or, yeah, even when he turned your CD player on.
Yeah, he just, like... It's like we're being such a rebel.
And he just, like, starts yelling out things randomly.
Julius! That was perfect.
Dude. So. But, yeah. Crazy Spaniard.
Crazy Spaniard.
Crazy Spaniard. Yeah. Got anything else on the ultimate list here?
I actually like to say that... I was looking forward to playing Ultimate Frisbee, but it did get canceled tonight, and that
was
something that
actually,
like,
yeah. Yeah, because, I kind of feel bad, because I built up all this anticipation for Adam, you know, described Ultimate Frisbee, all the good things about it, and how cool it is.
I always heard so much about it.
And I guess, like after the homecoming court announcements, I went home. Adam drove me home and showered, got in the car, brought it here, and you know, I get back to the school, and everyone's like, it's like abandoned. I was like, what the hell? And all the lights were out in the practice field, and I was like, what the hell? And I eventually found Adam. I've been going around for maybe 5 minutes looking for someone I recognize.
Yeah, I don't understand how you were like ultimate. You like took a shower. I like got home, changed. I left back. I was going fast there, and somehow you still. Did you beat me?
Dude, I might have.
I think you might have, because when I was back, like when maybe you got in there after I was talking to Sean or something, but I didn't see you. I don't know. I just thought that was kind of weird. I'm like, Mike's here already. Seems like he'd be a little later.
How long were you there whenever I drove up? How long have you been there?
I pulled in, I saw Sean, I was talking to him for a few minutes. I don't know how long, but I don't know.
I'm ultimate, what can I say?
That is pretty ultimate. How long was your shower? Like,
actually, minutes? It was a pretty good shower.
Wow, then
I didn't mess around. Well, I did, yeah. Like, because I was really dirty, because I had all the, like, the paint and crap on me.
Yeah, I know.
My hair's all, like, nice and clean. But I don't know. Oh, yeah. J-Lo. If you ever see this, just know we're going to get Colin's car for you. We're going to mark it again.
Oh, speaking of which, Colin apparently doesn't really want to see J-Lo, man. I'm sorry, but I was like, Colin, you know, J-Lo's coming. Don't you want to see him? And he's like, hell no, he pissed on my car. And I'm like, hey, man, you know, forgive and forget, bro. Forgive and forget. Me pissed Su casa, Su casa pissed my casa or something, man. Just forgive and forget.
What the hell was that?
I don't know. It's like, you pee on my car, I pee on your car. Even though Colin never peed on Jordan's car.
It's okay.
Jordan. Well, I mean, I kind of crapped in Jordan's car, so if that counts as...
I guess
like,
so.
Continuing the legacy.
I guess, you know.
So now Colin has to do something.
Green tea squirts.
He won't do something on someone else's car, so... I don't know. Whoever watches the video... I hope they know the whole, you know, Moab story, or else this isn't going to make that much sense.
That's
I'm going to have to sit there and explain afterwards.
You can reference previous videos, because I'm sure it's been explained a couple times.
Yeah, I'm going to have to say, like... I'm gonna have to make a video about the Moab, called the Moab story, and then explain it, and then, like, you're gonna have to watch that, so then I won't have to explain it. Simple. Sounds simple enough.
We could network them together with, like, crossover cables.
Yeah. So I think, appropriately, we should end with possibly Mega Man, Super Fighting Robot. Mega Man.
And this is Mike and Adam.
Mike and Adam, you know, signing out. It's been fun.
Signing off.
We'll have to say goodbye until next quarter or whenever we decide to make another video.
You think we should wait till Christmas?
That would be a long-ass time. I don't know. It all depends. I mean, if something dramatic
happens. Just, like, you think it's just convenient that it, like, took this long?
I think it's convenient that this song started playing, actually. It's actually a better song to end with. But this was definitely very convenient. I mean, this is going to be... I can already see this is a great video. I mean, 28 minutes.
Dude, you're actually...
Moving
yeah.
on off. Maybe we'll get the 30-minute mark.
I don't think we should press it, but...
I'm not trying to press it. I'm just saying, you know, it's pretty good.
I think it's close enough to 30 that it doesn't even matter, I mean, if we reach it or not. Because, you know, the standard's now been set. This is like... I think this is like the longest video.
It's a big show. Yes, it is.
Dude, that means Christmas time's going to be at least 45 minutes.
I was trying to get the whole big picture. So,
dude, how about Wendy's, actually? We didn't talk about Wendy's.
Yeah, we could just, as a wrap-up, Wendy's.
Well, basically, like, I was still in my cheerleading outfit today, and we decided to go, you know, over to Wendy's, you know, get a bite to eat. This is before I went home and showered. You know, a lot of people making comments, you know, thinking they're wise guys. But, it was fun. I had a fun day.
Mike basically ripped on this one dude that was like...
Actually, yeah, it was really funny.
Cleaning up the stuff, and it was actually really funny. Like, the guy couldn't make any comeback.
It was like, you know, like the guy who walks around, he washes off the tables, sets up the salt, and crap on the tables, and you know... what did he say to start it off?
I actually honestly don't remember completely. I think it was something about... something and you're like, are you hitting on me? And then he was like,
that was
no,
my
I got a wife.
That was my comeback. He said something, I'm like, are you hitting on me? And he's like, no, I got a wife. I'm like, is she inadequate or something? And I kept ripping on his wife.
And you were like, man, it sounds to me like you're trying to get closer to me, is what it sounds like. Is your wife not enough for you or something? And, like, he just couldn't back it up. I don't know, he couldn't.
He probably doesn't have a wife.
Obviously not, because that one girl thought he was in high school, so I don't think he has a wife. The one girl that gave us the Frosties. Great. And Wendy was there too, by the way, so.
Yeah, I'd make comments about Wendy.
We had to, we had to tell her how much we loved her.
Oh, it was like fun.
As we said before, this is Mike and Adam. We're signing off here. Until next time.